Doma Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now let's move up to the heavyweights. Something that's very interesting. I've been hearing the last day or two. I didn't believe it, right? I've heard that Anthony Joshua has called out Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz, right? So I've been knowing that for about a day. I'm like, I don't believe that. It'll be huge news. In the boxing community, that would be huge news. I wouldn't have to be looking for the interview nowhere. I'm hearing that some dudes, Ma'ak and Barak, or something for the Zone in the interview, that he called out Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz. So, seeing as though everything is up until now, that's happened with Anthony Joshua and Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz, I'm obviously a pessimist when that comes to that, right? The glass is half empty with that one. And that's because up until now, I haven't seen anything that would lead me to believe anything different. I'm going by what I've seen. So, of course, I'm like, that ain't true. If it were to be a big news, man, they'd be talking about that before they start talking about Trump. Okay, that's huge news, worldwide news. Anthony Joshua was called out Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz. So, I haven't found the interview because I was looking for it. Somebody send me a link if you got it. I like to do it, but make sure if you do, I will dissect it. Okay, but here's the deal. What I'm hearing is he mentioned Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz's name amongst others, that if he couldn't get the Wilder fight, then here's some other ones that he would fight. And he put his name in there. That's good enough. That's something. That is definitely progress, because I've never heard Ortiz's name from Anthony Joshua. So we're moving. At least he mentioned him. Now, I don't know how loud. And the reason why I didn't believe it is because I know this. When you mention Ortiz's name, right? We then gave him the name the Boogeyman. When you mention his name, he will holler at you. All you got to do is ask your countryman, right? Ask Dillian White when he tried it. All you got to say his name. You don't have to say it three times, like the Candyman. Excuse me, not the Boogeyman, because it's Boogeyman anyway, but we changed it to the Candyman. Don't have to call him three times. Once. So if he gets wind of his name being even mentioned from Anthony Joshua, because you got to remember, he said Anthony Joshua was wrapped in cotton. He said that Anthony Joshua will only fight him if he goes on disability, and he just never fight him. It ain't going to happen, right? So if this guy hears that Anthony Joshua mentioned his name, I know he didn't call him out. Calling him out and mentioning his name, two different ball games. Mention his name, hey, you know, I'll fight if I can't fight your boy Wilder, and we can probably get Tyson Fury. We can get Dillian White. We can maybe do a rematch with Joseph Parker, Ortiz, and Povetkin. You know what I'm saying? If you mention them like that, that's a far different than, look, Luis the Real King Ortiz, we sending you some paperwork. Holler back when you get it. Right? I don't think it was like, without even seeing it, guys. Because when I talk about Joshua, I like to do that without even seeing it. Why? Because I've been trying to put this on. Right? That's why. That I can never wear, right? Because I haven't got nothing wrong, right? That's the point about that. So that's why. Let's see if he really called him out, right? If Joshua really called out Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz, then we'll be having a fight. That will be the fight on April the 13th, because it's definitely not going to Luis Ortiz probably won't even try to price himself out of the fight, which I keep hearing that Joshua's talking about, people pricing themselves out of the fight. You know, no one's worthy. I've told you guys before, no one's worthy to fight him. I don't know what he wants to give everyone. No one's worthy to fight the guy. You know, so people just asking for, you know, decent percentages or anything. Hey, we're giving you a little bit more than what you made before ever. You know, and then people don't want to fight. I think Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz will fight him for whatever. I tell you what, if Joshua just mentioned his name, all somebody got to do is holler at Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz and tell him that. And we will have the response. And like I'll tell you right now, the response is imminent if he would call out Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz. So maybe we might have a fight on April 13th. But at the end of the day, I don't believe it's a call out. I'm going to watch the interview when I get it. I think he probably mentioned him, which is still something. It's still something. Don't get it twisted. You don't have to come in the comment section hating like you're doing on the video. I want to watch a few videos to get some information. Same people, you know, hating on everybody's comments like they paid from Anthony Joshua. Or a Matchroom or something. They go pay, they go in the comment section, and anytime somebody's not saying anything positive about Anthony Joshua, here they come. But at the end of the day, you can shut people up by him doing what people are saying he won't do, right? like somebody being able to predict everything that Anthony Joshua has done before Povetkin, Dillian White, or whatever, everything, and was right about it. Now, I don't know how somebody could come in and be upset about someone who keeps getting it right. Once I get it wrong, I've told you before, I'm prepared, willing, and able, and wanting to be wrong about it. But it ain't happening, because you can read it. Like I said before, if Anthony Joshua really did call out Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz, guarantee you the answer is imminent. Doma Sports Talk, worldwide. I'm about to hear y'all.